Hi students, today I will start our second unit, that is series. Here series is nothing but infinite series. First let us see what is the series. Okay, for this we need to consider two sequences, which are un and SN. Here UN and SN are two sequences of real numbers, because here in this chapter we will discuss only sequence of real numbers or series of real numbers. Okay, so now we define the sequence which is SN by the recursion relation. That means S1 which is equal to U1. That means S1 is the first term of the sequence UN. Okay, S1 is what? S1 is equal to UN. That means S1 is the first term of the sequence UN. Similarly, S2, which is equal to U1 plus U2. U1 plus U2. That means S2 is the sum of the first two terms of the sequence UN. Similarly, S3, which is equal to U1 plus U2 plus U3. That means S3 is the sum of the first three terms of the sequence UN. So on, SN is equal to U1 plus U2 plus U3 plus so on plus UN. S1 is nothing but sum of the first n terms of the sequence UN. What is SN? SN is nothing but sum of the first n terms of the sequence UN. Okay, next SN is equal to U1 plus U2 plus U3 plus so on plus UN plus so on, where N belongs to Z plus. That means SN is the sum of the infinite terms of the sequence UN. Here S1, S2, S3 so on SN are called as partial sum of the sequence UN. Here S1, S2, S3 so on SN are called as partial sum of the sequence UN. You observe that here UN is a sequence and SN is also sequence. But here the sequence which is SN can be defined in this way. Here the sequence SN can be defined in this way. Now the sequence SN is called infinite series. Here the sequence can be defined in this way. Now the sequence SN is called infinite series, which is denoted by summation n is equal to 1 to infinity UN, or simply summation UN. Here SN is called as infinite series, which is denoted by summation n is equal to 1 to infinity UN, or simply summation UN. Here we read this as SN equal to sum from n is equal to 1 to infinity u subject to n, or simply summation un. Okay, so here un is called nth term of the sequence, nth term of the series. So here un is called nth term of the series, and sn is called sum of the first nth terms of the sequence. So here sn is called sum of the nth terms of the sequence, or sn is also called sequence of partial sum, or sn is also called partial sum of the series. Okay, once again I will explain, please listen. Okay, so here sequence sn is called infinite series, which is denoted by summation n is equal to 1 to infinity un, or simply summation un. Okay, so here un is called nth term of the series, and sn is called sum of the first n terms of the sequence, or sn is also called partial sum of the series. Okay, sn is also called partial sum of the series, or sn is also called sequence of partial sum. That means finally we can say that series is nothing but sum of the terms of the sequence, or sequence of partial sum. Series is nothing but sum of the terms of the sequence, or sequence of partial sum. Okay. Here, series is a finite or infinite. According as its sequence is finite or infinite. So now let us see what is the finite series and what is the infinite series. Okay, finite series. Okay, now let us see what is the finite series. The sum of the first n terms of the sequence, or nth partial sum of the sequence, is called finite series. The sum of the first n terms of the sequence, or nth partial sum of the sequence, is called finite series, which is denoted by summation I is equal to 1 to n ui. Okay, finite series is nothing but summation I is equal to 1 to n ui. Finite series is nothing but the sum of the first n terms of the sequence, or nth partial sum of the sequence. Next, infinite series. Infinite series is nothing but the sum of all terms of the infinite sequence is called infinite series. The sum of all terms of the infinite sequence is called infinite series, which is denoted by summation n is equal to 1 to infinity u n. Okay, finite series is nothing but the sum of the first n terms of the sequence is called finite series. Infinite series is nothing but the sum of all terms of the infinite sequence. The sum of all terms of the infinite sequence is called infinite series. Okay, this is finite series, this is infinite series. Okay, now next, write down definition of series. If un is a sequence of real numbers, L numbers, then the expression u1 plus u2 plus so on plus un plus so on is called an infinite series. The series u1 plus u2 plus so on plus un plus so on is denoted by summation n is equal to 1 to infinity un, or simply summation un. Okay. Next, here, write down, here u1, u2, so on, un, so on, are called first term, second term, so on, nth term of the series. Okay. Finally, series is nothing but Sn, which is equal to summation n is equal to 1 to infinity un, or simply summation un. Okay. Series is nothing but sum of the terms of the sequence, or partial sum of the series. Okay. Or sequence of partial sum. Okay. Just remember series. Okay. Okay, once again I will explain. Okay, so here series is nothing but sum of the terms of the sequence, or sequence of partial sum, or partial sum of the series. Okay, so here un is called nth term of the series, so here Sn is called sequence of partial sum, or partial sum of the series. Okay. Series is nothing but just sum of the terms of the sequence, or sequence of partial sum, or partial sum of the series. That's all. Next, write down. Series of positive terms or positive series, series of positive terms or positive series. Okay, write down, if all the terms of the series summation un are positive, that is un greater than or equal to 0 for all n, is called series of positive terms or positive series. That means a series in which every term is greater than or equal to 0 is called positive series. That means every term is positive in the series. Okay. Next, write down alternating series. Okay. A series in which the terms the terms alternatively positive and negative are called alternating series. That means U1 minus U2 plus U3 minus U4 plus so on, okay, which is denoted by summation n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 whole power n minus 1 UN for all UN greater than or equal to 0. Okay. UN greater than or equal to 0 for all N. Okay. Alternating series means a series in which the terms alternatively positive and negative are called alternating series. That means alternating series is a series whose terms are alternate in sign. That means plus minus. Okay. So the form of the alternative series is summation n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 whole power n minus 1 un. Okay. So here un greater than or equal to 0 for all n. Okay. A series in which the terms alternatively positive and negative are called alternating series. Okay. Next, write down partial sum. Partial sums. Okay. If the series, summation un is an infinite series, then Sn is equal to U1 plus U2 plus so on plus UN plus so on is called nth partial sum of the series or sequence of partial sum. Here partial sum means if the series summation un is an infinite series, then Sn is equal to u1 plus u2 plus so on plus un plus so on is called nth partial sum of the series or sequence of partial sum. Here Sn, what is Sn? Sn is equal to u1 plus u2 plus u3 plus so on plus un plus so on is called nth partial sum of the series or sequence of partial sum. Okay. Next, write down definition of convergent and divergent series. Read on. If the sequence of partial sum partial sums Sn is convergent to S, then the series summation un is convergent to S. The limit S is called the sum of the series. That is, S is equal to limit n tends to infinity Sn, which is equal to summation un. If Sn is divergent, then the series summation un is divergent. Okay, write down definition of a convergent and divergent series. So now we are going to discuss about whether the given series is convergent or divergent. Now let us see. If a sequence of partial sum which is Sn is convergent, then only we will say that the series which is summation un is also convergent. Listen carefully. If a sequence of partial sum Sn is convergent, then only we will say that the series which is summation un is also convergent. Otherwise, the series is divergent. Suppose if the sequence of partial sum which is Sn convergent to S, then only we will say that the series summation un is also convergent to S. So here the limit which is S is called sum of the series. Listen carefully. Okay, if a sequence of partial sum Sn convergent to S, then only we will say that the series summation un is also convergent to S. Otherwise, the series is divergent. Okay, so here summation un is convergent if and only if sequence of partial sum of un is convergent. Okay, here limit n tends to infinity Sn means, limit n tends to infinity Sn is equal to S means, limit n tends to infinity Sn is equal to Sn means sequence of partial sum of un is convergent. That means limit n tends to infinity Sn exists. Limit n tends to infinity Sn exists means, what is Sn? Sequence of partial sum of un. What is Sn here? Sequence of partial sum of un. Here limit n tends to infinity Sn is equal to S means, limit n tends to infinity Sn exists. Limit n tends to infinity Sn exists means sequence of partial sum of un is convergent. Okay. Here, if the sequence of partial sums Sn is convergent, then only we will say that the series also convergent. So here, what is Sn? Sequence of partial sum. Okay, limit n tends to infinity Sn is equal to S means, limit n tends to infinity Sn exists. That means sequence of partial sum of un is convergent. Okay, if the sequence of partial sum is convergent, then only we will say that the series also convergent. So now let us see one example. Write down test for convergent of the series summation n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 by n into n plus 1. Okay, already we know that series is nothing but summation un. Okay, by comparing these two series, says here we get un is equal to 1 by n into n plus 1. Okay, already we learned partial fractions in second year. Okay, so here by partial fractions. By using partial fractions, here 1 by n into n plus 1 can be written as 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. Okay, please check it. Okay, by partial fractions, so here we have 1 by n into n plus 1 can be written as 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. Okay, so here first let us write u1 is nothing but 1 by 1 minus 1 by 1 plus 1 is nothing but 1 minus 1 by 2. u1 is nothing but 1 minus 1 by 2. Okay, similarly tell me u2 is nothing but 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 is nothing but 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3. Okay, similarly tell me u3 is equal to 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4. Okay, so on. Here already we know that Sn is nothing but u1 plus u2 plus u3 plus so on plus un minus 1 plus un. Okay, so now let us write what is u1. u1 is nothing but 1 minus 1 by 2 plus u2 is nothing but 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 plus u3 is nothing but 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4. Okay, plus so on plus un minus 1 is nothing but 1 by n minus 1 minus 1 by n. Okay, please check it. What is un minus 1? Okay, for writing un minus 1, just replace n with n minus 1 in un. So here we get 1 by n minus 1 minus 1 by n minus 1 plus 1 n. Okay, 1 by n minus 1 minus 1 by n plus un. Un is nothing but 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. Okay, you observe that here clearly in the first term minus 1 by 2, the term, if you observe that in the first term here, the term minus 1 by 2 cancelled with in the second term of the sequence. If you observe that here in the first term, minus 1 by 2 is cancelled with the term in the second term, with the term of the second term in the sequence. If you observe that clearly here in the first term minus 1 by 2 is cancelled with the term of the second term in the sequence. Similarly, if you observe that here in the second term minus 1 by 3 is cancelled with the term of the third term in the sequence. Similarly, minus 1 by 4 also cancelled with the other term in the sequence. Okay, next, finally in the term finally here in the n minus 2 term, minus 1 by n minus 1 is cancelled with the term of the n minus 1 term in the sequence. You observe that clearly here in the n minus 2 term minus 1 by n minus 1 cancelled with the term of the n minus 1 term of this sequence. Okay, finally minus 1 by n plus 1 by n get cancelled. Okay, so here finally we get 1 minus 1 by n plus 1. Okay, so next we have to find limit n tends to infinity Sn is nothing but one minus 1 by n plus 1, which is equal to 1 minus 1 by infinity plus 1 is nothing but 1 minus 1 by infinity is nothing but 1 minus 0 is equal to 1, which is finite. Already we know that limit of the sequence is finite, then we can say that the sequence is convergent. That means Sn is convergent. Already we know that Sn is convergent, therefore summation un is also convergent, because sequence of partial sum is convergent. Okay, so here series is convergent because sequence of partial sum is convergent because limit n tends to infinity Sn is equal to finite. Okay. And also sum of this series is equal to 1. That means sum of this series will be equal to 1. Okay, sum is 1 of this series.